For our site, we want to create a new page, or a new view, called the waterfall listing. This will be a useful feature because it will give a listing of waterfalls, allowing the user to filter by location and hike difficulty. Start by visiting the Views landing page at Structure, Views. We want to create a new view, so click on this Add View button. What we see first is only the initial configuration page. Let's get through this quickly. First, let's give the view a name. I'm going to call this Waterfall Listing. Enable the description checkbox and give a short description, such as lists the waterfalls on the site. This is what will show in the administrative view listings. And in this next section called Views Settings, understand this UI first. It reads as show something of type something, tagged with something, sorted by something. And don't worry, these need not be 100% perfect up front. Nearly everything in a view is configurable. Click to open and see this show dropdown. We want to show content of type waterfall. This is the new content type that we had created earlier in this project. For sorted by, let's choose the title so the waterfalls are arranged alphabetically. And then, in this next section, enable the Create a Page checkbox. I will go with all these defaults for now. The page title as Waterfall Listing, and the path as Waterfall-Listing. We can always modify settings later if required. Read through all the options. Notice that quite easily, you can also create a block. Don't do it now. You can experiment later with that. Now, the question is, what happens if you don't choose either the page or the block? The answer is, if you do that, a master view is created as a template with all your settings that will be saved and that you can later inherit or duplicate and create multiple usable pages or blocks from it. So, we are all done with this config page for now. Hit this Save and Edit button to proceed. This is the most important page, where you really create the view. It looks complex, and most new users get intimidated at this stage. But that will not be with you. I will simplify this page for you. There are two main sections to this page. The first up is called Displays. And at the bottom is the Live Preview section. The Displays section itself has three different columns. 1, 2, and there's one more here, 3. This preview is very helpful and it shows you exactly what is configured at this moment. I will look at it right now. It doesn't look exactly like what we want. So let's focus once again on this Displays section. And let's go through all the options one by one. First up is the title, and that is for the page title. Currently, it is Waterfall Listing, and it's fine. The Format section allows multiple styles, and if you click the current text of Unformatted List, you'll see that you have the option of a grid, HTML list, table, and unformatted list. Some of these will have further style settings that you can modify if you need. Notice that right now the unformatted list is selected. Keep it as it is. Under the Fields section, it currently says, the selected style or row format does not use fields. This is because in the Format section, we have selected to show content styled with the teaser display mode. We can't add fields right now, but we will do that later. Filter criteria allows you to select very specific content. You will be able to decide what is included or what is excluded. For example, the default filter of publishing status equal to yes tells Drupal to select only published content and excludes unpublished content. You can modify this if you want, or add more filters and also change the order of filters. All of that is possible. Next up is the sort criteria, and this will allow you to set the sorting method for the content that has been selected so far. Since we initially decided to sort via content title, the content should be sorted based on the title, and that is what is showing up here. So these are all the basic content manipulation options that you have. In this middle column, in the section titled Page Settings, your options are mostly all self-explanatory. For example, you can set the page URL here for better SEO, you can add a menu link directly from here, and you can also set view access settings if you want to restrict the view. Going further, you can customize the headers, footers, no page result behaviors, and pagers. It is simple to understand, but it is definitely not simplistic. For example, there is a lot of customization that you can do with the header and the footer if you want to. While we are here in this middle column, let's add this waterfall listings page into the main menu. Click on the link next to menu. This opens up menu options. Be sure to choose the normal menu entry. From there, you can enter details such as waterfall listing for the menu link title. I'm going to skip the description for now. For the parent menu, choose the main navigation menu. Keep the weight as its default. Remember, you can always reorder menu items by editing its appropriate menu. When you're ready, click Apply. Great! You have just added this waterfall listing page to the main menu. For this course, the focus is primarily learning Vue's functionality and less on the UI formatting aspects. In the third and rightmost column, we have a collapsible section called Advanced. Click on it and it will open up. These are choices that will help you build dynamic queries and also for you to make other technical choices. We'll see more of this in upcoming videos. The reason that this section is kept collapsed by default is that most of the time you won't have to modify anything here. Okay, so that was a detailed overview of the Vue's UI page. Before we leave this page, be sure to click the Save button. After you have saved, let's open the home front page in a new tab. The waterfall listing now appears in the main menu. Let's click it to visit. Fantastic! And with that, I will conclude this video, and we will continue our building shortly. In the next video, we will build a views block to list the waterfalls. It's going to be very interesting, so see you there.